Just as we have defined centroid for plane areas, we can define centroid for line segments also, and we see that topic briefly in this lesson. We begin the topic by considering a straight line segment, locate its centroid, and then go on to other topics. Let us consider this straight line segment AB, situated in coordinate system XY with x-axis and y-axis shown over here. Its length being L, we say that its centroid G lies at its midpoint defined by the distance L by 2 from either end. This idea may be easily extended to several line segments existing in a XY coordinate system. Let us consider two line segments to begin with and see how we locate its centroid. Towards that end, let us say we have two line segments shown here. Let us say AB is one line segment, BC is another line segment. We have considered two line segments meeting at one point, but you may consider one line segment here and another line segment here and find their centroid. It is possible. We know that for line segment AB having a length L1, your centroid for this line segment AB is located at point G halfway between these two. That is, the distance from A to G1 is L1 by 2. The distance from B to G2 is L2 over 2. That is what we have shown here. Let us say the coordinates of the centroid of G1 are x1, y1. The coordinates of centroid of BC are shown as x2 and y2. Now we use the concept of composite areas and apply it over here, because this is a composite line segment consisting of two primitive line segments, straight line AB and straight line BC. We will say that the centroid of this composite line object consisting of two primitives AB and BC is located by coordinates X bar and Y bar, which are given by the formulae shown here. That is L1 X1 plus L2 X2 by L1 plus L2, L1 Y1 plus L2 Y2 divided by L1 plus L2. Notice that this formula is very similar to the one we have seen earlier. You have A1 X1 plus A2 X2 by A1 plus A2. Similarly, A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 by A1 plus A2. In place of area, now the property of the line segment is its length. If you have more line segments, more primitives in the object, line object we consider, we add those terms L3, X3, L4, X4 and so on in the numerator, L3, L4, so on in the denominator. So given a set of, given an object consisting of a set of primitives, maybe a straight line, maybe an arc or maybe a curve, you can simply use this composite object concept and locate the centroid. As an example, let us consider a circular arc, a quarter circular arc with a radius of R, with its center located at the origin. We try to find the location of centroid of this circular arc by method of integration that we have used in the case of primitive areas. Let me bring up that formula for locating the x coordinate of the centroid. We will say that the x coordinate of the centroid given by x bar, as shown here, when g is the centroid, x bar is the x coordinate, is given by integral x dl over integral dr, where the integral is performed over the entire line segment that we indicate by symbol L here. Notice that this formula again is very similar to what we have seen earlier. We had integral x dA performed over the entire area divided by integral dA performed over the entire area. In place of area A, we got length L. We can extend it to volumes also later by replacing it with V. We'll see that topic later. Now that we have this, let us put several things in place, that is, write what is this DL, what is X, and so on. Just as we have done in the case of an area, we consider a small elemental length as shown here. The elemental length is shown here, and we consider it at an angle of theta with a differential angle d theta. With this notation, the elemental length we considered from here to here is given by r multiplied by d theta, where d theta is measured in radians. Similarly, the centroid of this line segment shown here has a coordinate r cos theta. Its x coordinate is r cos theta, y coordinate is r sin theta. That is, the distance from here to here is r cos theta, the distance from here to its y is r sin theta. Because we are dealing with x coordinate, let us write x is equal to r cos theta. With the elemental length and x coordinate of the elemental length in place, we can invoke this formula to find the x coordinate of centroid for quarter circular arc. So in place of x, we have r cos theta. Then in place of dl, we have r d theta. Again in place of dl, we have r d theta. With this, we can simplify it as shown over here. Notice that this point, let us say P of this elemental arc, will be at this point on the x-axis, where angle theta is 0, and when we span the entire arc, the point Q will come to a point on the y-axis where the angle is pi over 2. So the integral limits are 0 to pi over 2. That is quite straightforward to look at it. We'll simplify this integral. Cos theta has an integral of sine theta between the limits pi by 2 and 2. D theta integral is theta between pi by 2 and 0. We will get 2r over pi. That is the distance of the x coordinate of the centroid of the circular arc is given over as 2r divided by pi. Similarly, it is very easy to see that y coordinate of the point of the centroid of this circular arc is given by r sine theta. Thus, y bar is integral between limits pi by 2 to 0. Integral of sine theta is minus cos theta. We simplify the integration to find that y coordinate is given by 2r over pi. So the centroid G is located at a point with x coordinate x bar and y coordinate y bar. We'll try to see another example to illustrate this. As another example, consider another composite line consisting of two segments, segment AB, which is a circular arc of radius 20 centimeters. And the second line segment is BC, which is a straight line segment, horizontal straight line segment with a length of 20 centimeters. We can locate the centroid of this circular arc at a point G1 with a suitable coordinates 2r over pi, which we have computed just a while ago, and the centroid of this straight line segment BC will be halfway, that is 10 centimeters from point B. Let us try to show an x-axis and y-axis here, and then go to further details. with the x-axis and y-axis laid as shown in the figure here. Okay, we have coordinates of g1, we have already computed just now, 2r over pi, that is 2 into 2040 over pi, 2 into r by pi, that is 40 over pi here, and the x coordinate of point g2 is ob plus bg2. OB is 20, BG2 is 10, so its x coordinate is 30, y coordinate is 0. We'll try to follow a tabular method by properly entering all these things into a table. Similar to what we have done in the case of locating the area of an object, let us try to do that systematically here also. To save time, I have built the table completely here. We'll go over each cell of the table. We have two objects, that is why we have serial number 1 and 2. The serial number we indicate by I. The two objects being arc AB and line, straight line segment BC. The length of the segments represented by LI, for row number 1, that is when I is equal to 1, for arc AB it is pi r over 4. We have 5 pi, pi into 20 by 4, and similarly the length of the second segment is given to be 20 centimeters. The location of the centroid of arc, that is this point G1, is having coordinates 2r over pi, 2r over pi, that is 40 over pi and 40 over pi. We have already computed the x coordinate of G2 is 30, y coordinate is 0. With this, we'll find the lengths Li xi, that is 5 pi multiplied by 40 over pi, which comes to 200. Again, L1 multiplied by y1 also comes out to be 200. Then you have L2 x2, that is 20 multiplied by 30 is 600. L2 y2, 20 multiplied by 0 is 0. Just as we have done in the previous case, we'll sum these columns, that is L1, Li, Li xi and Li yi. We got the total area of the line segment given by 20 plus 5 pi. This is 20, this is 5 pi, 20 plus 5 pi. L1 x1 plus L2 x2 is 800, L1 y1 plus L2 y2 is 200. With these, we write x coordinate and y coordinate of the centroid of this composite line object as L1 x1 plus L2 x2, that is the sum of this column given here, divided by the length of the line segment, which is 22.4. Similarly, y bar is L1 y1 plus L2 y2, that is the sum of this column, divided by the length, which comes out to 5.6 centimeters. With that, we locate the centroid somewhere here. Okay. As an example, let us try to see one more problem. But before we get away from this problem, I would strongly encourage each and every one of you to stop this video at places where it may not be very clear. Try to work it out and then go to the subsequent portion. In the next example, we have a composite line object consisting of three segments. All the three are straight line. One is AB, the next one is BC, the next one is CD. That is, this line segment spans into three dimensions. The line segment AB of 20 centimeters length is along z-axis. The line segment BC, which is along y-axis, has a length of 10 centimeters. And the third segment CD is lying in xy plane and parallel to x-axis with a length of 30 centimeters. We'll try to show how to compute the x coordinate, y coordinate, z coordinate of the centroid shown here. I've already shown the centroid just for the sake of illustration. That is, we'll try to compute x bar, y bar, and z bar. We'll again use a tabular method to show all these details at one place. Before we go to the task of laying down the table and entering values in there, let us see that this g1 has a coordinate 0, 0, 10, because g1 is a point on z-axis, its x and y are zeros, and along z-axis you need to go a distance from point B to g1, which is midway, 20 over 2 is 10. Similarly, for g2, it is a point on y-axis, so its x component and other component, z component, are z coordinate are zeros, and we have to go a distance from B to G to halfway of BC, that is 5. Similarly, for G3, you have coordinates 10 and 15. It is very important that you note the coordinates of centroids of each segment very carefully before proceeding further. To quicken the process, I have already shown the table here. There are three objects in this composite. That is why we have serial number 1, 2, and 3. Object 1 is the straight line AB. Object 2 is straight line BC. Object 3 is CD. The length of each of these are given to be 20, 10, and 30. The x coordinate, y coordinate, z coordinate of G1 are given to be 0, 10, 0, and 10. That's what we have entered, 0, 0, 10. That's why we have Li, Xi, that is L1, X1 as 0, 0, 200. Similarly, the coordinates of G2 are 0, 5, 0. That's why we have the products L2, X2, L2, Y2, L2, Z2 as 0, 50, 0. Similarly, the coordinates of G3 are given as 50, 10, 0. I don't know whether I think I made a little mistake here. I think earlier we made a mistake in noting the x coordinate and y coordinate. The x coordinate of the point G3 is the distance from C to G3. CG3 is half of CD, that is 15 as shown. Similarly, the y coordinate is the distance from B to C, which is 10 centimeters as shown here, and obviously z coordinate is 0. So these correct values are entered here, 15, 10, and 0. The product 30 multiplied by 15 is 450, 30 multiplied by 10 is 300, 30 multiplied by 0 is 0. Now we'll sum the columns Li, LiXi, LiYi, and LiZi, and as shown over here. This LiXi, that is L1 X1 plus L2 X2 plus L3 X3 is 450. Similarly, L1 Y1 plus L2 Y2 plus L3 Y3 is 350. And the third, L1 Z1 plus L2 Z2 plus L3 Z3 is 200. Now that the table is complete, we'll write expressions for X bar, Y bar, and Z bar. X bar is given by this, which is obtained to be 7.5. Y bar, you can see, is obtained by 5.83. Z bar is obtained by 3.33. Using these three coordinates, we will show the location of point G as shown here. We go by a distance of 7.5 along x-axis, and by a distance of 5.83 along y-axis, and 3.33 along z-axis to locate the point G. The idea is really simple. We simply extend the concept of composite area to length and substitute L wherever you see area A. Okay, we'll try to see subsequent topics in the next lesson.